Jeff here at the Kaddie Shack. Hey guys, today on Tech TV, we're gonna walk you through everything you need to build a beam. Now, whether we build it for you, you build it yourself, we've got a whole website here coming up. Check out our build a beam deal on the website. Shows you exactly, we'll walk you through the options. There they are right there, on how to build, and we'll walk through that. How to build a beam complete. Now, we can build it for you, we can supply the parts for you, whatever it takes, we're gonna help you get this thing done. So we'll roll up our sleeves here. Let's talk about, first of all, let's talk about the beam itself, okay? This beam here, it's a Brazilian beam. This one happens to be a 2-inch narrowed beam. So we offer beams in 2-inch narrowed or stock width. We don't go 4, 5, 6, 8-inch narrowed beams. They don't work very well. When you start narrowing beams that far, they tend to have, the people that do it, they've used like these cheap bushings in there, the trailing arms wobble in there. We like performance here at the Kaddie Shack. You know that already. We like performance. We like these things to drive. We like them to drive well. Now, why do you go with a narrowed beam? Sometimes you need a narrow beam to get the right wheels up under the front of the bug, you know. Our beams here, they're gonna fit a bug, they're gonna fit a Ghia. They won't fit type 3 or bus, they'll fit a thing. We offer them in ball joint, or we offer them in link pin configuration, okay? Our beams retain the factory bearings. We want the factory roller bearings in these beams to keep those arms nice and tight. They have the factory bushings inside. Like I said, they're not some sort of wobbly, cheap, squeaky, crazy deal. They're pretty nice stuff. They're a Puma beam. So originally, if you don't know about the Puma was a car that was made in Brazil. It was a really cool little car. They made all sorts of modifications. Dude, in fact, they came in a factory with cat runs on them. So naturally, they're gonna work well with what we do. The Puma, this is the Puma style beam adjuster. Check it out. Now, these are the adjustable beams. You can see the little teeth in there. It's got a little ratchet deal. We go ahead this beam is all preloaded. It's all set to the highest level. You can drop it down when you're done. When you set it up, you set the car down, drive it for a little bit. We set them at the highest level possible, okay? So this particular beam has to have, it has stock or drop spindles on it. We'll get to what spindle options are later. But we set them at the highest level possible first to start with. And then you have gravity working with you. Once your beam settles in, your springs settle in and everything, you have gravity working with you and you can loosen these adjusters, retighten them down exactly where you want to have them, and then have the height exactly where you want. Now, this beam here, the way it's built, it just happens to be one we've got that we built. It's going to be set up with 2.5-inch drop spindles. It's going to have when you put the car on it, it's going to be about 2.5 inches lower in the front. Now, if you want to go a half inch more, you're going to need to monkey with the adjusters a little bit and drop it down, and then you have it exactly where you want it. So it's really nice, really flexible, keeps the wheels inside the fenders, all that stuff. So where do we go from here? I guess we kind of talked about the beam itself. This is the beam itself. The beam, you know, is going to come just this piece. If you want to order just a beam, order just a beam. If you want us to help you with all the little pieces and parts, we're going to walk you through exactly how to do it. Come back over here to our build a beam deal here. Okay, now we've got this one is a stock, well, actually it's a 2-inch narrowed beam. Now, you need leaf springs. Now, I'm going to say we're going to add narrowed leaf springs. We have brand new leaf springs available, okay? This beam has the new leaf springs in them. We can use brand new ones, so you don't have to use your 40, 50, 60 year old leaves. They're brand new leaves. If you want to cut your leaves, you cut them, do it. Great. You have to have a special bit to make the notch. You have to cut them with either a die grinder or a chop saw. We can actually narrow your leaves for you. That's in the drop down option. So if you want to send us your leaves or bring your leaves in, we can narrow them for you. Next thing we go down here, tie rods, tie rod ends. Check it out. There's a bunch of different options there, okay? I'm just gonna click the first one, narrow tie rods and standard ends, whatever. We'll get up into the tie rods here. Now this beam here, I guess we'll go this way over here, probably easier, okay. This one here has got the narrow tie rods. So they've been narrowed to match the 2-inch geometry, okay? Now we have them in the standard tie rod here. We don't have the narrow ones in chrome, but we do have chrome tie rods available for the standard width beams. We've also got different tie rod ends. You can use the standard ones that they come, the narrow tie rods come with. They're made in China. They work fine. The boots tend to go bad after a couple of years or whatever. You can change boots on whatever you want to do. Or we've got actually the German, made in Germany. This one is a German tie rod end, okay? We have several different options for that. Or great. Going down to the very next thing here, Zerk fittings, okay? Zerk fittings here, we put brand new Zerk fittings in that thing. When you put this beam together, before you put the leaves in, okay, you're gonna wanna take a tap and you're gonna tap that those threads out because this beam's all painted. Tap that thread out, get the paint out of it or whatever, put your Zerk fittings in. Use your old ones, use new ones, we've got them, okay? We can even send the grease cartridge. There's a grease cartridge with it as well. Now, we can send it along if you want grease. You don't have to go anywhere else to get it. Trading arm grease seals. Check it out. This one has the urethane grease seals. They're kind of cool. They're red. They're cool. They work great. They don't squeak. If you want the urethane grease seals, great. We got them. We've got, also got the stock style grease seal here. This happens to be a ball joint. What is a ball joint beam? Okay. Trading arm grub screws, okay? A lot of times what you'll find is these grub screws get all boogered up. See that deal there? Let me get a little pointer. I think I got one right here. There's a screwdriver. There's a grub screw. You're going to need four of them. There's a grub screw and a grub nut, okay? One's here, two on each side. That's what those are right there. All right. Sway bar. Dude, we're big on sway bars here. Again, at the Kaddie Shack, we really like to drive our cars. We drive them hard. This sway bar here, this is a heavy-duty 3/4-inch sway bar, okay? This one is for a lowered beam. We have lowered sway bars for the lowered beams. We have stock sway bars, stock width. If you need to order a sway bar, we've got them. They come with the urethane bushings these are optional, the easy clamps, stainless steel clamps, urethane bushings. I don't have a urethane bushing up here. I probably should have had one sitting here. If you want to reuse your stock beam, you can't do it on a narrowed beam unless you cut it and weld it, and then it's not going to be a sway bar anymore. You can take the temper out of it. But if you need just clamps, you just want to do whatever, there's an option for that on the website, okay? So that's, now, what does a 3/4-inch sway bar do? It helps that car from tipping going around corners. So, you know, when you go around that corner and you're leaning over in the seat trying to keep the car over, dude, that sway bar is going to keep that car a lot straighter. You would be way amazed how much better a car runs with a big performance sway bar on that thing. I've got one on my car, front and rear. You know, we'll get into the rear one some other video, some other day. We're just dealing with front end right now. Dude, do a sway bar. My opinion, there you go. You can't get them, again, for 2-inch, 6-inch, 8-inch, 12-inch, whatever narrowed beam tricycle-looking thing you got, you're not going to be able to get them. You can't get a sway bar except a 2-inch beam. That's another reason, just we want to use just quality performance products that all match and work well together. All right, we'll go over here now. Sway bar, grease seal, we did that. I skipped ball joints, check it out. Let's go back to ball joints. Now, this one here, we have TRW ball joints in it, okay? Here's the ball joints. There you go. They're fine. We'll get to what they are in a minute. Now, we've got a bunch of different ball joint options available. The TRW ones or the Nakata ones are the best ones that we found to work. They last a long time. They work really well. We can get German ball joints. However, German ball joints, dude, don't call me later. I'm telling you now, don't get the German ball joints. They're really stiff. And everybody who I've ever known that has those German ball joints complains about how bad their ride is. I'm telling you now, don't do it. We've got, MP's got a couple ball joints. They're pretty decent stuff. You know, the rubbers on them don't last quite as long. So you may have to service them after a couple of years, maybe change the boots or something on them. I do have them for those that have the, don't have an unlimited budget. They're less expensive. We do have a lowered ball joint. They do make a lowered ball joint for that. So if you're just going to drop the bar, drop the beam with just adjusters, okay, and you're going to try to put that thing as low as you can, the increased travel, the lowered ball joints have an increased travel. And for the off-road cars going the other way, they have an increased travel going up. If you're going to use drop spindles, dude, use the TRW ball joints. There you go. Okay, next on our list, man. We need shocks. Okay, again, we got a lot of options for shocks. Most guys are gonna like the KYB, we call them the soft ride shocks. They're a gas shock absorber. They're a nitrogen gas shock absorber. That's what this particular beam has, okay? We do have the KYB, the road handler shocks. They're stiffer, okay? If you're gonna race that thing like slalom racing or course racing, something like that, you're probably gonna want the stiffer shock. It's not gonna be as comfortable on the street. We do have Impy shock, which is a gas shock, also nitrogen filled gas shock. It's not the KYB. It's kind of an in-between kind of difference. It's not a bad shock, it's okay. And then some people are just sold, dude, I have to have oil shocks. Impy makes an oil shock. It's a pretty good shock. The oil shocks, if you know anything about shocks, look it up on the internet. When you start bouncing that thing around and it starts going up and down, the oil in the shock actually bubbles in there and then creates a little flat spot. So it does ride super soft, but it doesn't do a lot of shocking. Okay? All right, so that's our shocks. Check it out. Dude, we've got shock nuts. So one of the parts of the, one of our goals here at the Kaddie Shack, try to get every single part you need on this beam on one sheet so you know there's no surprises. Oh man, I couldn't put this whole thing together, I'm missing a part. Dude, you're not gonna be missing a part. You go through this little tutorial. We've got the lower shocks, okay? the nuts. If you got a, you need a nut, it's on the build, okay? On a link pin beam, this happened to be a ball joint beam. On a link pin beam, we have upper shock bolts also available, okay? This is not gonna have it because they come with the shocks. All right, we need a steering damper. Look, dude, we've got steering dampers. Come on over here. This one is the Sachs Bode steering damper, the best steering damper you can get on the market right now. We do have the Impy steering damper also available. It's the Chinese kind of knockoff of this one. Works fine. You want the best one? Use that one. Or use your old one. But check the tunnel. Steering damper, check the damper. If it goes like this and it doesn't do any damping, you need a damper. If there's a big puddle of oil on your tunnel, it needs a damper. Okay. Next on our list, steering damper bolt and nut. That would be this piece here. Again, all of the hardware. We use a bolt here. We nut it on the back side. The steering damper has a nut welded into it. We double nut it here so this doesn't back out. Steering box. Check it out. We got steering boxes. Again, we've got a couple options for you on the boxes. This is a TRW box, okay? The best box you can get on the market right now. It's like a factory box, brand new, okay? The box is not gonna come with any hardware. We have Impy boxes available also for the budget-minded. The damper bolt and nut, string damper bolt. Nope, I just did that one already. String box mounting bolt washer kit. We've got hardened string box mounting bolts. I said it right. And there they are. There's one on that side, one on this side. They're a hardened bolt. They work great. The right size, all that stuff, da 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 da. Okay. If you go down the list a little bit more. Okay. Do you need a steering box mount? Well, this one has the factory style mount. Dude, you can reuse your mount. No problem. Okay. We've got new mounts. If you want over a turnkey beam, it's all done. You want us to do it. Or a new mount here. We've also got a billet aluminum one, dude. This thing looks pretty cool. Pretty nice little mount. You know, mounts up the same way. Okay. Polished aluminum steering box cover. If you want the billet mount and the billet cover, that goes right here. I don't have the bolts out here right now, but this the billet cover will also come with new bolts. Okay. Kind of a dress-up thing. It's kind of cool. Like street ride guys really like that stuff. Maybe sand rail, whatever. You can't really see it in most cars, but it's there, it's cool. It's available. Steering box mounting clamp, we just went over that. Steering box shaft coupler. Okay, we've got the shaft coupler here. Now we call this the shaft coupler. Okay, that's this guy right here. It'll come with a bolt in it. That's the steering shaft coupler. Okay, the next thing on there is a steering donut. That's the donut. Now we've got a couple of different donuts available. Ooh, I didn't grab one to throw one out here. This is a stock one. We use the best quality stock ones we can find, you know. We also have the red urethane ones available. We have black urethane ones available. Then we get mixed results with those things there. I know Miguel's got one of those red urethane ones. He's on his car probably 8 years or so, 6 or 8 years. Works fine. He likes it. Other guys say, nah, it cracks. I don't know, whatever. It's available. I prefer the stock coupler for whatever reason. There it is. We've got both of them there. Okay. Steering box, pitman arm. Now, pitman arm, maybe you don't know what a pitman arm is. It's the steering arm. It's this arm here, okay? It goes through, connects to the tie rods right there. Cool. We've got brand new ones available. Check it out. This one here is available. This is a late model one, Baldwin car, so it's going to have this little deal here for the stopper, okay? We have the bolt available. You'll see it in the little deal there. We've got these available for the early ones and for the late ones. In chrome also. So if you're a chromey homey kind of dude, yeah, we got one available for you. These are the steering box, what do we call them? Steering box, the mounting bolt stoppers. Now these stoppers here, can you see it from that angle? Maybe from the other angle. Check it out. Here it is there. This one here, I can't really rotate the steering box. When the steering box comes around here, it hits this so you don't, when you turn toward the passenger side, it doesn't go too far so you can make adjustments so your tires won't hit your fenders. The other one over here is doing it for the other side of the car. So this arm here hits that one. There it is. Okay. Drop spindles, disc brakes. Dude, if you really want your car to ride right and you want to drop it, don't just drop it with the beam. Put drop spindles on it. We have them available for drum brakes or disc brakes. Now, let's start with the drum brakes. How's that? Drum brakes. If you put drop spindles on for drum brakes and you decide later on, hey dude, I'm gonna add disc brakes, you're gonna be buying drop spindles again. They're not compatible, okay? So if you're gonna upgrade to disc brakes, do it now while the doing is good. We have the disc brake kits available with or without drop spindles. We have the disc brake kits available for the standard 4x130 Volkswagen pattern. We have them available for the 5x205 VW pattern, which is also the early Porsche pattern for the Speedster guys. This one here happens to be what we call the double drilled one. This is also drilled rotors. They're lightened rotors. This is kind of all the high quality, really neat stuff. These are double drilled. They have the Porsche pattern on the one set, and then you rotate it over a little bit. These are Chevy pattern also. So they're double drilled, Porsche pattern. You want to use Chevy reels? You found some Chevy wheel that you like? Dude, we've got it already. It's a bolt on, boom, done. With link pin, ball joint, doesn't matter. Okay? Now, we have these available in various combinations for drop spindles or stock spindles. If you want to use stock spindles, they're there. Okay? That's what all this other stuff is down here. So, for the, this particular one has TRW. This is a really, really, really high-end beam. It's a nice beam. We have put TRW calipers on it. They are available for the 66 and up four lug or the Chevy Porsche pattern setup, okay? These are TRW calipers. The calipers that come with the standard kit are fine. They work fine. They break great. We've used them on cars for a ton of cars. They work great. So you want the nicest stuff, we've got them available. Again, we try to provide you with every single option that you're gonna possibly need to build this beam to your specs. All of the kits we have available with the drilled rotors, if you want drilled rotors. The extra expense, they're nice. I mean, they're pretty nice. They're lighter, they're gonna shed heat better. If you're racing and stuff, or you just wanna look cool, do the drilled rotors, they're cool. You don't need them? No, they stop the car for you. What else we got in here? Camber adjusters. Okay, this is a ball joint beam. We have camber adjusters for this. Let me show you where those guys go. This is probably the easiest picture right there. That's it right there, okay? The camber adjuster, as you move this adjuster, okay, that helps with your steering alignment, okay? Camber adjuster washers. We put two washers under here. The factory puts one big, thick one. You can't really get the big, thick one anymore, so we use two big, thick, hardened ones, okay? Those camber adjusters we use allow for more adjustment than the stock one. So when you have a lowered beam, you might need that more adjustment, okay? Where else we got here? Camber adjuster washer, wheel bearing, seals kit. Okay, The disc brakes, they come with the wheel bearings, and they work fine. They're Chinese wheel bearings, but for the front end, they work great. For the rear end, I really, really like the quality wheel bearings. If you want the really the best stuff, we've got a better quality wheel bearing setup for you that's come with the German seals and the FAG bearings and all that kind of stuff. Or the Mikai, what is it? I don't remember. Anyway, the better bearings, okay? They are available as an option. We'll give you, if you need to order a can of disc brake grease, dude, it's even on the bill. So we've got the right grease for it. Spindle nuts and washers, okay? You can't see them here. In fact, I don't even have them here. You know, the ball joint beams and the length pin beams, they have the spindle nut. The length pin beams have the double nut deal. The ball joint beams have the one nut. The left-hand, right-hand thread comes with the little Allen screw that you tighten down and a special washer. They're in there. They're under the grease cap. You can't see them on this beam. They're under the grease cap. Well, if you need grease caps, we even got grease caps right there, okay? Okay. Beam installation pads. You know, you have an option. Now, your pads, these are the rubber pads that they come with a beam. They go right here. One sandwiches the body's right here. The one goes under it. We've got a couple of different sizes for you, okay, depending on your body. Sometimes you have body sag and stuff. The body sits on there. The rubber washer fits on there, okay? And then you put the bolt in right there. So if you need to do beam pads, which you probably do, we'll send you a kit, okay? Not a cat. Got a cat? We'll send you a kit. It comes with a couple different sizes just in case your body's sick, okay? The last option as far as the parts go is caster shims, okay? What are caster shims? They fit right behind the beam, okay? You bolt them in right there. Can you see them through there? You can see them. There they go, okay? And when you install the beam, you can use caster shims on that thing. What that does is it tilts out your beam just a little bit, okay? When you start lowering the car a little bit, that if you tilt that beam out a little bit, the car's gonna go straighter. It's a little bit harder to turn, not really noticeably, but you tilt the beam out, you put a little more caster on the beam, it's gonna drive better. I personally like to stack two of the shims together. Now, these shims here, they're 2 degrees. They give you 2 degrees of beep, okay? If you put two of them together, you go ahead and look at my car right now, I've got two of them in there. When you've got two caster shims in the thing, then tilt it out even more, let go of the steering wheel, it's gonna wanna go straight. And none of that darting all over the road. It goes straight, okay? When you put two shims in here like this and you stack the shims just like that, okay? You're gonna need to use a longer bolt on the bottom hole only. Top hole's fine, use the bottom hole only because it's tilting that beam out. We have them available. When you wanna put the beam in, the shims are here. Okay, next let's talk about the labor. You want us to build a beam, dude, we'll do it. It'll look like this one. Do you want to just order the parts, build it yourself, put it all together. You can just have us do some of this stuff, okay? Let me get back to the parts real quick one more time. Because we're doing this happened to be a ball joint beam, link pin beam's a little different. We have king pins available, king pins and link pins, okay? And we prefer the German stuff here, okay? These are the Phoebe Bilstein German. Good stuff, okay? The budget stuff we have available, it works fine. It just wears out quicker. So if you want the quality stuff, we got the quality stuff. You want the other stuff, we don't have. We have the other stuff available. And you can buy whatever. I mean, it's there, it's on the sheet. If you want it, great. Now, getting the labor part, again, going back to labor. We can install all this stuff for you. If you want to install it, order the kit, order the parts, order whatever parts and pieces you need, whatever you need. Boom, done. Okay? You want to send us your parts? I would have us rebuild it. Send us your steering box clamp and your arms and all that stuff, then that's fine too. Trailing arms, there's a core charge on those. We go to swap meets and Craigslist, whatever, we find trailing arms. So if you need trailing arms, and hey man, I'll send you mine when I get to the back, that's fine. There's a core on there. It's, you know, just get us your ones back. We don't want the money, we want the arms. You know, that's it. Okay. Labor. There's some tricks to this. Well, I'm sure we'll be shooting videos at some point. Like how to install the leaves. You got to grease every individual leaf. You got to wrap them in wire, get them through here, feed them through here, set all this up just right. It's a messy job. As soon as you get on that thing, the wife's out there, she needs some help opening the pickle jar, you got grease all over your hands, a fly lands over your nose, you gotta go to the bathroom, you know what happens there. You've got grease all over, it's a pain in the neck job. We put the springs in the beam for you if you want us to do that, okay? And when we do that, we're gonna do the, before we put the springs in, we're gonna do the zerk fit. So if you wanna do it, ask to do the beam, you need to send your zerk fittings so we can, remember we gotta clean those threads out, put the zerk fittings in, okay. The next operation would be install the ball joints or in the lead pin beam, we can do the link pin, okay? We'll install them on the arms, send your arms in, use our arms, take a core, whatever happens, we can install the ball joints for you, or the link pins and king pins, rebuild your whole spindle for you. Okay, install the sway bar. I'm not gonna install your sway bar, okay? Don't send that thing in, it's kind of a waste of time. But if you want us to install the performance sway bar, you're buying a sway bar from us, we can install it once the arms are on, you know, we can install it all. And actually, getting back to that, I think we've been, we replace your arms. We have to obviously have the arms on us to install the sway bar, okay? A lot of people do, they want to order a brake kit from us only, but not everybody has a wheel bearing press. So, and with all the right fittings and all the right bits and all that stuff to put the wheel bearings in the rotors, if you want to order this brake kit from us and you want us to just press the races and the rotors for you, we can do that and send you the brake kit with the rotors and all the other parts. You assemble it all or do it all together. That's what that's about. Okay. We install the spindles and the brake kit. When we install them here, we're gonna paint them. It's gonna be black. If you want them purple, then you're gonna have to go somewhere else. Okay. We'll install them. We're gonna paint them. We're gonna take all the time to paint your arms and all the other stuff. It's gonna look nice. You know, we're trying to do that so they don't rust and corrode and all that. And plus, we take a little pride in what we do around here, and it's just nice to have nice stuff, right? Beam final assembly. The final assembly kind of thing, dude, is for the guy who's like, okay, I've already installed that. We've done the arm. We've done everything else. Put everything else on. Make this thing turnkey. Pretty much done. We're going to install the string box, the pitman arm. We're going to do the adjustment bolts. We're going to do the arms. We're going to do the shocks. We're going to put the ball caps on. We're going to install your string stabilizer, all the other stuff. Pretty much, that's the turnkey deal. So if you want the whole turnkey beam, click that option, it's done. It's, I guess, pretty much it. I mean, we wanted to go through every little part and piece for you so you understand what all the drop-downs are and so you don't have any surprises. When you get home, I know how it is. You order something online, you're all excited to get it, you wait a week, 2 weeks, whatever to get it. You get it all there, you go to put it on the car, and it's like, dude, I'm missing, like, this thing. And with this program, our Build-A-Beam program, you're not going to be missing something. It's all there. We've walked you through every single piece, every part. Look at our shipping terms. You know, if you want us to build a beam, we're going to have to crate it up, okay? There's going to be a crate. We're going to have to charge a crate charge for that because we got to spend time building the crate for you, get it out, get it to Alabama or Mississippi or Alaska, wherever you are. And then we'll help you with the shipping and all that stuff, trying to get a decent rate. You can read through our shipping terms. You can see that. The last thing on there is the beam order terms. Okay. We build a lot of beams. And when you call us up or you click the enter or whatever, we start a beam. We start ordering the parts. Maybe we need this particular brake kit and this particular thing over here. We're starting to press ball joints, trying to do all that stuff. You got to understand, we really can't cancel that order. I mean, we're working on this thing for you to try to get you a product in time so you can have it. And that's basically what the beam order term is all about. So we want to build the best quality product for you. If you have questions, we've got the answers for you. There's more beam videos coming, so you can have assembly questions if you want to do it yourself or whatever. But we've got the best program out there. It's the only one that we know of anything like that where you can select exactly what you want. And I just think it's a great thing. And you should be really, really, you will be really, really, really happy with the product and how this car drives and how it handles and how it looks. And we just, you know, want to thank you for going through the whole thing with us and ordering with us. And we really, really, really appreciate your business. We want to make your car really, really right. That's it. Take care, guys.